Welcome back here with us on Times Now. Let's get you the latest update as far as India's Covaxin is concerned. The vaccine being manufactured by Bharat Biotech. Now, a study was conducted by, Indian Council for Medical Research. It was conducted by the U.S. National Institute of Health, and it says India's Covaxin, developed by Bharat Biotech in collaboration with the Indian Council of Medical Research, effectively neutralizes both alpha and delta variants of coronavirus. NIH has said that results of two studies have suggested this. Let's go across to Sharon joining us on the broadcast. More on this. Sharon, this is very encouraging. The result of two different studies which suggest that, you know, Covaxin is effective in neutralizing both alpha as well as delta variant of coronavirus.
Absolutely, Hina, and this is a major endorsement when we talk about Bharat Biotech, who have in fact now recently submitted their third phase data as well. Now, the U.S. National Institute of Health has in fact in their study said that the Covaxin has been effectively neutralizing both alpha and delta variant of coronavirus. And apart from that, they have been saying that the results of the two studies that they have conducted, the blood serum from people who received Covaxin suggested that the vaccine generates antibodies which effectively neutralizes the alpha as well as the delta variant. So this is, of course, a major boost for Covaxin. We have already seen that their interim result of phase 3 trial indicated that the Covaxin is 78% efficient against the symptomatic diseases, while it is its efficacy against severe COVID-19 cases are 100%. So now this study once again proves that the Indian vaccine, Covaxin and Covishield, because we have seen number of studies which have suggested that both alpha and delta variant has in fact Covishield and Covaxin have been very much effective against alpha and delta variant. But all these answers, of course, leads to one question: what about delta plus variant? And those studies are still not available. And accordingly, ICMR have said that the studies are in ongoing process. And in coming days, they also will be revealing whether Covishield and Covaxin, how effective they will be against Delta plus variant. But as of now, this comes as a significant development where it has shown, the study has shown how Covaxin neutralizes, both has been effectively neutralizing against Alpha and Delta variant.
Right. Sharon, request you to stay on with us. In fact, there's another important update that we are getting for our viewers, and this is about the approval that has come from the Drugs Controller General of India for the fourth COVID vaccine in India, which is the vaccine by Moderna. Let's go back to Sharon, who continues to be with us. Sharon, so this approval came yesterday. Firstly, tell us, what does it mean? Will this now be available in India for people? And second, what happened to the indemnity that, you know, this along with Pfizer had sought before coming into India?
As of now, it is a regulatory approval that has been given by DCGI for Moderna. They have also granted Cipla, which is the partner of Moderna in India, to in fact import. They have in fact approved the import licensing for Moderna. Now, this basically means that Moderna can in fact, a vaccine can in fact come to India and it can be inoculated, can be vaccinated with it. Now, as of now, what Cipla statement last evening has been saying is that though an emergency use approval have been given to Moderna, but it may come as a donation at first. Remember, just few months back, United States, in a goodwill gesture, had decided to send vaccines like Pfizer and Moderna to third world countries, including Asia, countries in Asia, and around 16 million vials of Moderna will be reaching Asia. So a minimal number of quota will also be given to India. So as of now, Moderna is going to be as part of a donation. But at the same time, now that the emergency use approval has been given, it can also have a commercial agreement. But as we speak, it is only as a donation that is going to reach India. The commercial agreement is something that in coming days, it will be in fact discussed between the government of India as well as the manufacturers of Moderna. As far as indemnity that you have asked, indemnity is something that has in fact been still discussed upon. It is a matter that is still being examined, is what the health ministry on record has said. But this is in fact a major boost, because we have been talking about Pfizer and Moderna for months altogether, and finally Moderna, as part of donation, will in fact be reaching India anytime soon now.